Okay, I'll be completely honest with you guys. I have been feeling the effects of this diet lately. And as the deeper I've been getting into this diet, which is, I'm coming up on 12 weeks right now, caffeine consumption has increased significantly, dramatically. It's insane. But with that being said, the diet is coming to an end soon. I've reached like my goal weight. I've lost around 24 pounds in those 12 weeks. And in this video, I kind of just want to go over how to get shredded, how to cut, my approach to this whole thing, which has made it fairly simple. It's a fairly simple and easy approach. So I'll show you what I had for breakfast, and we'll get on with the day.
I think I'm on the verge of a breakthrough.
My typical breakfast right now is just egg whites, 2 cups of egg whites, 1 cup of oatmeal. Game changer while dieting, and this is essential. I do 1 scoop of greens powder, just for health, and then 2 tablespoons of Metamucil. I got the idea from Mike Beach and Matt Vincent. Metamucil while dieting, extra fiber, game changer. The deeper you get in the diet, it'll make more sense. I just need some love, it's been a while. And she just posted a pic and I'm like, wow. Oh Lord, got me stressed. Now, tracking macros and calories isn't absolutely necessary or essential during dieting, but it eliminates one variable, and that variable being caloric intake. So the more accurate you are and the more consistent you are with your caloric intake, the better the results you're going to get. So that's why I track macros. And this past week, I literally spent like 3 whole days building my website. It's nickbearfitness.com. I'll have the link in the description box below. But there's a part where it shows you exactly how to set up your macros. So I'll link that. And if you need help setting up your macros and finding your maintenance calories, it walks you through everything. Now here's like one of my favorite dieting hacks, fat-free Ready Whip. It goes like perfect on oatmeal that's mixed with like cinnamon and sugar-free syrup, like, or calorie-free syrup. Every time I buy this though, Preston gets it, and I have like 1 serving left, if that. So this past weekend, I had to take my car in to get fixed because one of the tires had a hole in it, had a nail in it. And when they were servicing it, they realized that when I did my 1200 mile service inspection, they never took it like electronically out of break-in mode. So like electronically, the turbo wasn't functioning at full power, the engine wasn't functioning at full power. I took it in this morning to BMW, they fixed it. It's like a brand new car. It drives a lot faster. There's gonna be a lot more trouble.
It must be, cause the nigga got dough.
Not even an exaggeration. Probably the easiest buffalo chicken dip you'll ever make. It took me a total of like 5 minutes. So all that's in here is 1 serving of fat-free cheddar cheese, 6 ounces of just pre-cooked and then cut up chicken breast, 1 serving of this Bolthouse Farms chunky blue cheese, a little bit of Frank's Red Hot Sauce, 4 ounces, or it's like half one of these, like 112 grams of fat-free cream cheese. And then I just threw it all in a microwave, cooked it for 1.5 minutes, and then 200 grams of celery. So my tolerance for hot stuff is not the best, never has been the best. Frank's hot. It's about as hot as I go. Nose is running. So here I am talking about dieting in this video, and my baby brother Preston is about to get in and out. So like it's crazy how you can feel your body changing just meal by meal. So like because that meal had so much sodium in it, the buffalo sauce, I can literally feel my arms filling up, like the blood moving to the muscles and getting more vascular right before this workout. So 1 scoop of Flight, Pina Colada, and then 1 scoop of Endopump Fruit Punch, which works very well. I just got back from the bank, so we're now moving on 5 pound containers of protein, which is our next move. So here's how I lost 24 pounds in the last 12 weeks. Prior to this cut, I stopped tracking macros. I was just eating intuitively because I was just tired of tracking. I was just eating mainly healthy, clean foods, but staying in a surplus. So when I got back to tracking, I used the calculator that's in the link below to find my maintenance. Now you can trust these calculators and these equations, but I always say trust but verify. So use the equation, find your maintenance calories, and then test it to see if those are actually your true maintenance calories. So stay on those calories for say about a week, and if your weight stays the same, those are your true maintenance calories. After that, to go into a deficit, losing about 1 pound a week, and the goal should be 1 to 2 pounds of weight loss per week, depending on how much weight you're trying to lose and in what time duration, you go into about a 500 calorie deficit per day. So you take your maintenance calories of what it takes to maintain your current weight each day and subtract 500. Now that 500 calories can come from diet alone, cardio alone, or a combination of the two. In the beginning, I did strictly a 500 calorie deficit through diet. And then towards the end, as I got deeper into my cut, I incorporated a little bit more diet, a little bit more cardio, and a combination between the two to continue losing weight.
I'ma call, see you on TV. Sunset shit done changed. Ever since we was on, I dreamed it all. Ever since I was young, they said I wouldn't be nothing. Now they always say congratulations. Worked so hard, forgot how to vacation. They ain't never had the dedication. People hating, say we changing, look, we made.
A lot of the stuff I'm touching on in this video is also on the site that I just published. So up there is also a free 12-week training program, which is essentially what I'm running right now, minus the strength training stuff. So the program I've up there is strength focused, it's hypertrophy focused, and you do squat, bench, and deadlift once a week in 4 muscle cycles based off a projected 1 rep max. So kind of the program I'm doing right now is just all high rep stuff, like 8 to 15 reps, hitting everything twice a week. Abs every other night, and then cardio 2 to 3 times a week, just like 15 minutes on the stair stepper. Now to get into the fun stuff, making adjustments. So the resources that I recommend, one is MyFitnessPal to track your macros, free application on your phone. The second one is Weight Drop, and this is how I track my weight every morning. So I just input it, and then it shows you progress over time, and it gives you some good analytics and reports based off the data you input. A food scale, and then just a scale you can weigh yourself every morning. So I weigh myself every morning as soon as I wake up, after I go to the bathroom, before I eat or drink anything, and it's the most consistent weigh-in of the day, and I keep track of that, and that's how I base my adjustments to my macronutrients for morning weigh-ins over like periods of 1 to 2 weeks. I don't make adjustments too frequently. Another way I can tell I'm getting leaner right now is that when I'm sitting in my car with my wallet in my back pocket, it hurts my butt because I have less fat on my body, and it just like it's extremely uncomfortable. It's just like one of those conscious things, like you are officially getting leaner. So I'm realizing now how much of this car I was missing out on while it was in, braking mode. While I was in braking mode, I did not take advantage of its full potential. This is one of my tricks to making dieting a whole lot easier. So I call these flex salads. One whole bag of lettuce. There is a serving of fat-free cheddar cheese, some low-fat or reduced-fat Parmesan cheese, pico de gallo, tomatoes, a chopped-up pickle, 75 grams of avocado, some mustard, Bolthouse salsa ranch, and then 6 ounces of just grilled chicken breast in this massive, massive bowl. Now, one of the biggest questions I always get from people is when to make adjustments to your macros. So, like, do you set it to a certain period of time where you make adjustments here and there? And that's what I initially felt when I first started tracking macros when I did my first bodybuilding show in 2013. So my biggest recommendation is always go and do your initial 500 calorie deficit and test those macros for 1 to 2 weeks. Because a lot of the time, for example, over the past 12 weeks, I've had inconsistent weigh-ins. So say, for example, I wake up today and I weigh 1 to 2 pounds heavier than yesterday. There's a lot of different variables that could contribute to this around your hands. Sometimes the stress alone will cause you to gain weight and retain water, and that's what's causing inconsistent weigh-ins. But over time is when you're looking for those trends. And 1 to 2 weeks is when you can assess those macros and your weight and make adjustments then. So you don't want to make adjustments right away, but test those macros for 1 to 2 weeks and then make the adjustment. Now the next question is probably when you know how to make these adjustments and how do you make the adjustments. So after that first initial 500 calorie deficit, you ride that out as long as possible. If I'm still losing weight, I just ride those calories and those macros out until my weight loss stalls or plateaus. Once it stalls or plateaus, and like I said, give it 1 to 2 weeks to assess those current macros you're on, I don't go into another 500 calorie deficit. I just make small tweaks like 100 to 200 calories at a time and then reassess after that after a week or two. So I'll pull like 25 grams of carbs and 5 grams of fat. Primarily, you're manipulating your carbohydrates because carbohydrates are a higher percentage of the calories you're consuming. So like maybe 25 grams of carbs, 5 grams of fat, a little extra cardio. You can do a combination and experiment with a deficit in calories, a deficit in cardio, or a combination of the two. Okay, so right now it's like 10:30. I killed macros around 6 p.m. So like my macros right now are 250 grams of protein, 200 grams of carbs, and about 55 grams of fat. And I usually hit like at least 30 to 40 grams of fiber a day. Now, when I first started the diet, I was at, I believe, 350 grams of carbs, 250 grams of protein, and around 75 grams of fat. So you can see over those 12 weeks, slowly in increments, I've dropped carbs by 150 grams, and I've dropped fat by about 20 grams. Like I said, it's in very small increments, typically like 25 grams of carbs here, 5 grams of fat here, and then slowly incorporated in more cardio the deeper I get in the cut. So that's the video. And if you have any questions, nickbearfitness.com. I'll have a link in the description box below. You can download programs. I have a cutting one-on-one program, a 12-week workout program. Check it out.